me, can I get a light? Roll you up and let it run through my veins. 'Cause I can always see the farthest stars when I'm on you. I don't wanna ever come down off this cloud of loving you. Now you got me hopped up on that.
Good morning, and thank you for tuning in to the Live in 5 show, where we are living live and Disneyland bound, 8th graders.
Okay, the popular show Pawn Stars is coming out with a new game show, since the original show has been a hit since 2009.
Stanley Cup is going into Game 5.
And will it still be good for Disneyland today? More on that.
A company by the name of Valve is creating a console named called the Steam Machine.
On May 27th, a donkey and a goat reunite in California.
That's really newsworthy.
Kind of news.
That's so newsworthy. I love goats. We'll be back on the other side.
Now, hey, little.
Why can't I remember this?
I love this highway on too, and I know that you're so.
Welcome back.
Now it's time for the test off play-by-play.
What?
No. What high school are you going to? This video asks our graduating children what they're going, where they're going.
Christian here, interviewing 8th graders about what high school they're going to go to.
Yeah.
What high school do you want to go to? Why or why not?
You're so dumb.
I want to go to Cerritos because it's really close to the library.
I want to go to Cerritos because most of my friends are going.
Cerritos because I live right next to it.
I want to go to Cerritos because all my friends are going there.
Go to Artesia because I know a lot of people there.
I want to go to Cerritos High School because that's where we're going to be near when we move.
Cerritos because it's a pretty good school.
What do you like about that school?
It's just close to the library, so I can go there after school and work on homework.
My sister goes there.
I have friends there already.
What extracurricular activities are you planning to do?
I have no idea.
Tennis.
Probably the rallies.
Football, because I signed up for it, so yeah.
What do you know about that school?
Not much.
I live close to it.
There are a lot of Asians there.
Not really. All I know is that they're dons.
What will you miss about Tetzlaff after moving on to high school?
I'm going to miss all the teachers and the studio store.
I miss all the teachers and all the 7th graders here.
I would miss Ms. Stoffers, the music that goes on every Friday.
Nothing.
The studio store. There's lots of food.
What will be the most exciting part about your high school year?
A new start.
Nothing.
The girls.
There are several different high schools in the district. Each of them have a variety of elective courses involving technology, art, and foreign language. Every high school in the ABC USD district is exceptional, and every Tetzlaff student will go to one. Hopefully they don't have a hard time of making a decision of which to go to. It seems like most of the 8th graders are going to enjoy their high school year. Well, I'm Christian. See you back in the studio.
Today is the Disneyland trip for 8th graders. Turn
Yay,
up. Let's
I
get turned today. And 7th graders with a GPA of 2.0 or above will receive popsicles. Also, tomorrow is the cap and gown distribution for 8th graders.
Matthew Scammerhorn delivers our final funny segment of the year.
Hey, Trojans. Malvi here for one last time showing you some vines. Today's vines are just plain weird, so enjoy these vines.
Hit it for two times.
Bruh, bruh.
Hit it for three times.
Bruh, bruh, bruh.
Let's get it.
Bruh, bruh.
He's so funny, blah, blah, blah. I think he was in the U.S. for quite some time. Yep.
He was at that Razor House they got going on over by NASL.
Watch out for my body rolls, watch out for my body rolls. High kicks, this is...
Those vines were pretty weird. And also, Did you know that you can visit Vine from a computer now, not just your mobile device, by going to vine.co? All right, that was the last Vine compilation of the school year. Hope you had a good school year and enjoy the summer.
That's it for the play-by-play at Tets Off. We'll be right back after the break.
Thanks. OMG, I have the power!
Hi, can I see your yearbook?
Sure.
Stop calling me, can I see your yearbook?
Sure, homie.
Hey, can I see that?
Wow. I got the power!
Professional high jumpers cleaned up all the aisles and cleared the grocery
the
store.
Produce.
It was the jumpers' old hometown and they wanted to give back. Many people who were interested attended this big event and stared in awe as professional jumpers used their skills to jump all over the tall jump bars. These professional jumpers did this just for entertainment and will be back for the next time they train.
Thank you, Janaya. I like jumping. It's fun. Now, let's see what's going on in the world of entertainment with Alyssa. Good morning, Alyssa. How are you this fine morning?
Thank you, Dylan. The popular show, Pawn Stars, is coming out with a new game show. Since the original show has been a hit since 2009, this new show will be set in Las Vegas and taped in front of a live audience. In each episode, the contestants will compete against each other, and the Pawn Stars will have a series of trivia questions. How can this be a computer fighting a console war? A company by the name of Valve is creating a console called the Steam Machine. Valve is working together with the company Alienware to make the next gen console. The console prototype was shown during the E3 convention on June 9th through June 12th. The console was pushed back to 2015 by Valve product designer Eric Hope because the controller's design was found unsatisfactory by the developers. The console will be a Steam OS Linux-based Steam Machine. Any game that is regularly played on a popular console will run smooth as butter on Valve's new weapon. Let's see what's going on in the world of weather. Good morning, Jorge.
Well, 7th graders, I hope you missed us while we, the 8th graders, are enjoying our time at Disneyland.
All right, let's get to your forecast. We have 68 in Los Angeles. Perfect weather. We have 108 in Phoenix. Yikes, that's hot. I'm getting hot just talking about it. We have 102 in Las Vegas, 91 Albuquerque, 82 Oklahoma City, 75 Kansas. The majority of this area of the nation,
70s, high 60s around there, but with some partial clouds. And for the rest of the nation, we have 81 in Norfolk, 80 in Washington, and 74 in New York. Time now for your 5-day forecast. Today we have 73 degrees, slowly rising up to 75 degrees tomorrow, then again slowly rising to Saturday on 78 degrees. And then slowly decreasing to Sunday on 74 degrees, and then Monday will drop down 1 degree to 73 degrees. All those days with partial clouds. Time now for Wet Pole with Dylan. Good morning, Dylan.
Hi. Thank you, Jorge. Austin with us. Good morning. Can you please do the Wet Pole for us?
Should Tet Sloth be allowed to have energy drinks on campus?
Here's what you said. I don't care because I am hyperactive either way. Another one of you said, no, because my parents won't allow it. We want to hear from you. Be sure to visit us online on 15showtovote. Sending comments to hashtag 15poll or email us at webpoll@15show.com. It's good for you to have the air. So Austin, you think you have energy drinks?
No, because I've heard of some energy drinks being unhealthy.
Okay, thank you. And here's Johnny with sports.
Thank you, Dylan. In hockey, Rangers beat Kings 2-1. Kings lead the series 3-1. In baseball, Athletics beat Angels 7-1, Reds beat Dodgers 5-0, and Nationals beat Giants 6-2. That's it on sports. Time now for the Daily 411 Challenge with Dylan.
Thank you, Johnny.
Okay, guys, what is the fastest ride at the Six Flags Magic Mountain in California? King Dicka, Goliath, Batman, or Bizarro? Take five. King Dicka is the fastest ride in Six Flags Magic Mountain. It reaches up to 128 miles per hour.
On May 27th, a donkey and a goat reunite in California. The odd thing is they are best friends. They were best friends when they were small, but when the goat named Mr. G got rescued, he wouldn't do anything but mope around. No one knew what was wrong with him until a farmer named Jan Galezzi figured out Mr. G had a long-lost best friend named Jelly Bean. Mr. G and Jelly Bean were best friends from the start, but when they got separated, they both started acting funny and wouldn't eat or do anything. He decided to drive 14 hours to get Jelly Bean. When she got unloaded, they were overjoyed to be reunited once again. That wraps up the show for tomorrow. Follow us on today. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at Live 5. We'll catch you back here tomorrow.
Push it out, girl. Ain't you? Yes, yeah. Just my little push it out, girl. Ain't you? Since you came around.